In the Palestinian state of Gaza, there was a building that housed the offices of the Associated Press, a non-profit news agency, and another news agency called Al Jazeera. On May 15th, an Israeli airstrike flattened the building. The attack sent alarm bells ringing across the world, and countries were worried over the escalating Israel-Palestine violence. On 16th May 2021, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu was invited on Face of the Nation, an American news program. During the show, he spoke about the ongoing violence between Israeli forces and Palestinian militant group Hamas. Netanyahu said the airstrike was conducted as they had received information that the building housed a Hamas intelligence office, which was plotting the attacks on Israel. On learning this, we conducted the airstrike. So it was a perfectly legitimate target. However, there have been no injuries or deaths, only the building has been destroyed. Associated Press head Sally Busby said, "We are not supporting either Israel or Palestine in this conflict. We are neutral. Israel say they had information about Hamas intelligence office in the building that was planning attacks on Israel, which is why they conducted the airstrike. But there is no proof about this yet. We do not want Israel or Palestine to investigate the matter. We want an independent investigation into this matter." After nearly a week of Israeli airstrikes and Hamas rocket barrages, Netanyahu gave no time frame for when Israel would stop the fighting. United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres has pleaded for an immediate end to the deadly Israeli-Palestinian violence. He warned that if the fighting continued, people will die in large numbers and it could be very dangerous. The USA has been Israel's long-term ally. After the airstrike on Gaza, US President Biden made a phone call to Prime Minister Netanyahu Biden told Netanyahu that he understands that Israel has a right to defend themselves, but he is very worried about the safety of journalists amidst the violence. Many Indians are unhappy with Benjamin Netanyahu. Let me tell you why. On 15th May, Benjamin Netanyahu posted a tweet and extended his thanks to various countries for their support. He had included the flags of these countries. However, he did not include the Indian flag in this thank you post. Many are upset that even though many Indians have pledged their support to Israel, but the Prime Minister did not thank India. Others are asking Prime Minister Narendra Modi to clear his stance on the issue.